Hey guys, how's it going? Welcome to an episode of Hearthstone 4 Modern Day Vatican City. So I just finished up my first Steel Division stream and yeah, it was quite fun. Well, I'm not gonna actually spoil, but it's gonna be up in a couple hours for those who ask for it. So, Vatican City, where are we? Yes, we are at war with, let's double check. So we're at war with you, small little nation over here, and we're at war with... Let's see. Oh, wait, we're at war with two people. Yes. Okay, where the hell are you now again? Let's see. Poof. Alright, this small little island. Oh, god damn it. I forgot about that. Okay, let's bring you down. And let's basically just continue down here and just bring more and more nations down to the fold. Are we justifying war against anyone? No, we're not. I think I want to justify war against you, Social Democrat. Who is the leader of the European Union? Or basically, yeah. NATO, that's you, United States. So, and you are conservative with Trump as head. And let's see. Is there anyone, like, leader? So, yeah. Well, of course, European Union, NATO. No! Stop saying NATO all the time. Social Democrat. Okay, Social Democrat, you might be a tiny bit... dangerous to attack. You too. Not you. Social liberal. Okay, justify war goal against you. And let's see. How about you? Nationalist. It should be safe to justify war against you, so let's do you too. Cool. You're gonna push in... Actually, 155 days. That's gonna be slower than just waiting 66 days. So, actually, the penalty is increased. Maybe it will go fast. Oh, whatever. Let's just do it. We're wasting a tiny bit of political power doing that way. Whatever. We have enough political power to do some stuff back and forward a bit. And let's see, you. Let's move you, well, forward. Let's see, do we want to nuke anything right here? I would think you would basically fall quite quickly. Do we have any planes assigned right here? Yes, we do. Do we have any tanks assigned? Yes, we do. You two are slowly getting here. So basically my plan to actually get over here and actually land is... My tanks are pushing in, and then I'm just gonna nuke, and that's gonna be it. And actually, I should just fix my camera now. I completely forgot about that this time again, so let's just reduce it. Maybe a tiny bit more. No. Okay, let's just do it this way. Oh, actually, we already have a camera. I can't actually see it. Oh, there. Discord settings. Oh, cool. Hello. Let's see. Oh god, I don't have a shirt on myself. Horrible things. So, yeah, basically, you charge ahead. And then when you're fighting... Hello, little island. Let me select you. Let me nuke you. I know that they are not gonna fall by national unity, but what they might fall is if they don't have any equipment. Since they're engaged in combat, they should not be able to reinforce. And now, that's the best way of taking over an island when you don't have anything to do. Or when you don't have any, well, good division to actually do naval invasions. So yeah, that's how you end the war. You nuke them a billion times until they beg to surrender. You four divisions, get over here, push down, please. That means you are done basically right here. We probably have to repair all of this, so, well, okay, that's kind of bad that we have to repair everything because it will probably take quite a while, but we're focusing on so much other things. I think we will be all right. We should probably just set this up too, just in case. Yeah, let's just include Switzerland too, since we probably want to invade them too, and we'll probably fall back from there. Actually, that's a lot of provinces we could just ignore. Okay, for now, let's remove a couple of them at least. Yeah, cool, that was all of them. Actually, maybe one more could be get removed here on the side. No, okay, it was perfect. I'm just perfect. Both of you. So, one each. We're slowly getting a higher and higher amount of tanks on each side. The divisions are well, that we're facing are also getting better and better, so I'm kind of afraid right there. Let's see, we are doing fine with mechanized equipment, well, kind of fine. Tanks, pretty good there too. So I think it's time to at least start to increase our tank division to one of those godlike divisions we made before. Let's see, someone said they tried it out and said it was really, really good, so I really want to do it myself now. And let's see, mechanized, 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 mechanized. So we're gonna miss, we have enough, we're missing 21,000 mechanized. We have enough motorized and infantry equipment by far. We don't have any motorized rocket artillery, but that's very easy to get. And main battle tank, we're gonna miss so much of them. Alright, so let's do a slight difference right here. It's fine actually with rocket artillery. We're gonna gain back that very quickly. Let's see. That looks a tiny bit better. Just a tiny bit. If I remove all of those, that would give me some back. And not give me such a massive penalty. Okay, we're gonna do this. Save that. Delete all of these. And just let them recover and get back right here. So we're gonna miss 6.4k mechanized. And we're gonna miss 100 battle tanks. So we should probably increase the amount of mechanized we're currently producing. Even though we have a couple of lines on it on the way. So let's just increase it by even more. No, you should be pushing down. Actually, do you have a level 10 fort there? Yes, you do. So that might be a bit hard to break. Hello, tank. Hello, airplanes. How about you move down first there and you add some strategic bombers to this entire pile? Because if I have them, then I can do some, well, interesting things right here. As soon as you arrive, we'll see some explosions. We will see some explosions on their capital and it's gonna be beautiful. Come on. How long before you actually arrive? Wait, did I mess up? No, you should be on your way. Really? I should be able to see them right here. If I'm not completely wrong. Okay, something happened. I'm not really sure what, but whatever. Okay, nuke them. Let's nuke them again. Okay, that was unnecessary for the second nuke, but, well, whatever, we're fine. And let's just go in and grab that province now. Come on. Oh, wait, we probably ruined the entire infrastructure in this entire place. So my tanks will be much slower now. 3.6, because infrastructure minus 50%. Of course. Let's do construction repair. Just try to fix up every damaged territory we have taken right so far. And that is a lot. Let's actually promote all of the forts right now. Very good. Come on. So cool, that should be the surrender of you and the end of that war. Maybe. Yeah, it should be the end of the war. Cool, thank you. Congo, take all states. Democratic Puppet of Congo, take all and take all. And that's a pretty nice amount of bonus factories and manpower to us. Very nice, thank you. So, do we have an extra right here? No, all of them are already instantly assigned. Very good. Very good indeed. Oh, we have a bunch of mechanized coming right here. Should be fine. So, how much are we missing? 1.8k mechanized. Oh, we have really increased the production capabilities we have. So wait, we were just fighting war against you, and you just finished up, cool, and you have another, well, 100 days, let's see, how dangerous are you, social democrat, okay, you're a tiny bit dangerous too, conservative, that should be fine, 155 days, yeah, okay, let's do it, everyone gather around there, yeah, actually everyone, cool, we have both Fist of the Pope still ready and waiting, very, very good, so yeah, we're just building up. Building up even more soon so we can face off with the European Union. God, it's gonna be a very hard battle and I'm probably gonna I don't think I will lose. I think I will lose a lot of men, a lot of power, and it will really take something special for me to actually bring them down, but I think I can do it. Yes, we can. Yes, we can. Yes, we can. Alright, and let's declare this war. And let's just bring them down from all points around us. Yes, charge in, I don't care how you do it, just get in there. That's only one division, right? Stop it, stop attacking. Attack from two sides, which increases this one, which means two divisions at the same time. Alright, I totally forgot to check the combat width. Well, 54. Well, we're probably gonna increase that quite soon. Come on, you can do it. Actually, why are you pushing in right here? Let's just push in and grab the capital right away. And let's nuke them. That's where winning wars. Nuke them. Thank you. And the only bad thing is actually because we want the stuff because of the factories. So if you nuke them, everything is going to be damaged. Right. I might have to stop nuking every single enemy I have. We'll see. It's fun to nuke. Alright, you 24 divisions. Let's just remove all kind of orders you might have. And let's just sign you right here. Because I'm just fighting against you and you. Yes, cool. 24 division, gather up. And now actually regroup and get there. We have low taxes, we have heavy regulated. Do we want heavy regulated? Our current consumer goods is at -1%. Okay. Now that's because of this one. We all other bonuses are taking out each other, plus minus zero. Population growth, we have 800 every month. So basically, I think we started out with the Vatican City with around 700 people, right? Or is that completely wrong? Was it more than that? Or 800 maybe? So, basically, we're almost gaining in recruitable population the same amount as I had when I begun this campaign in total. That's pretty cool. We have expanded quite a bit. So 18 million people and 2 million. Well, I like you better, Zimbabwe, because, well, that's going to be a lot more men fighting for me. Everything is slowly being built up. Very good. God, it's going to be a hellish war once this finally breaks out. Switzerland guaranteeing. Some people talked about maybe I should try to bring down Russia before I do this. It might be a really good idea, but then I have to somehow get to Russia. And that's a big problem. How do I get to Russia? I think I have to go through Arabian Republic. Iraq. No, wait, you're in NATO now. Okay, I need to go through, well, Arabian Republic. Get to the Islamic Republic, Iran, Turkmenistan, Uzbekistan, and then go into Russia this way through Kazakhstan. Or maybe China. That would basically be the same. God damn it. It's a lot of targets we have. Right now, it's just so tempting to just go through nation to nation right here because it's a lot of manpower and, well, a lot of factories. And they're basically very, very easy to grab. But still, looking at this manpower, it's very, very tempting. Only this area, 132 million people. That could be quite many nice divisions for me. Okay, how would I get there? The best way would probably be attacking these people. Coup in the European Confederacy has succumbed to public demands. The politicians now ousted and replaced by a new, more popular movement. Oh, nationalist. And you should get kicked out of NATO now. So the thing you talked about in the chat were coming true. They're nationalists right now and yeah, we'll see what's going on. You should be kicked out of NATO. And that is at least a bonus. Then I don't have to fight you and the United States at the same time. Which is, really a big bonus. The two largest and strongest nations. Actually, only strongest nation. Maybe not. Okay, I would pretty much say that the third strongest and the strongest nation, them getting split apart, that's a nice bonus. That's a nice bonus. Alright, how many more days before I declare this war? Another 40 days, so let's just continue. Let the game run. And let's see, how good are we now in equipment? 6.9k mechanized and 2.2k tanks. So let's finish this off, I think. Mechanized right here, and we are we basically have enough. We're gonna have enough. We just wait wait longer time, and we only have a couple small wars to declare, so I think it should be fine. So I think we added a tiny bit more stuff. Like I wanted, I think, one more rocket artillery. I think I went for one more tank. Basically, we need to reach 18 limit. And one more thing, like another tank maybe. Another mechanized, how much do you have? Oh, a lot more actually. So let's add one more tank here. And when we have this, we are basically done. Yeah, we're doing it right now, and then just, this is what we're missing, let's just wait until we have it, while taking down smaller nations. And then we'll start to make plans for a larger target, either China, Russia, or go straight for the European Union. I think that might be advantageous, just going straight for the European Union right now. I think they're in the position where they're very strong, but they aren't fully ready just yet. They have built up, they have reinforced everything, and I would say they're almost in perfect shape. But almost, not yet. So I think it might be a good timing to bring them down. Just bring down a couple more smaller nations. Prepare an air force to just grab one territory somewhere and just nuke the crap out of them. Like, if I manage to grab the southern France air zone for just a short while, I can drop two nukes here, two nukes here, two nukes here, and that would be a really big penalty on their national unity, hopefully. Let's see, how hard would it be? Yeah, quite hard. We are doing fine with doctrines, right? Air doctrine, no, crap. Air superiority 20%, yeah, definitely this one at least to begin with. We're starting to low manpower, yeah, because of all the extra manpower going into every single division right here. 20,400 right now. That's quite a bit. And we're actually having too much units right here now. So I'm gonna just go like this. Half of you are now gonna return and get right here. You 12 are gonna be assigned here, but half of you assigned right there. But we should have enough supply here. Yeah, that will definitely be enough. So I'm gonna do all of this with only 12 divisions right now. They should still be doing really, really well because, well, I refuse to say that they will fall. Yes, because they're 12 now. They have 1,367 soft attack, 580 hard attack, and they're not even fully stacked just yet. They're still missing tanks, and there are still mechanized. Oh, light mechanized are also used. Okay, cool. Well, we're missing 10,000. So that was why we didn't get such a big penalty first in mechanized. Yeah, 8,000 tanks. We need to raise manpower law. Let's go to extensive. Oh yeah, that's basically no penalties at all, and we got another 740,000, that's really good. Declare war right here, U12 divisions, you should just go in basically. Holy shit, did you see that? I think we can do this. Oh well, at least if you have any organization at all. You're doing quite a bit of damage, so if you just have your organization, I think this will be just fine. So everyone right here, please just hold on for a short while and let's get your organization back on track. Let's attack with... Oh god, you're just losing it instantly. That's interesting. Is it a river or anything? No, it's just a forest. So let's double check. Your current organization is super low. Right, I might have gone with a bit too much tanks. I need to improve the organization by some way. Is any one of these improving organization? No, I don't think so. Removing them will. Of course. We'll see what we can do. We'll see what we can do. Right, what are we going with? Oh, right here. I kind of want to go down this now. We change it, basically. We go down all the way. It will take a very, very long time. And that will... I don't want to wait that long before declaring war upon maybe European Union or anything. Though going down this way would be really good. That would just increase our tanks by quite a bit, and we would lose, well, we would basically not lose anything when I think about it. The only thing we would lose are 5% extra recruitable population. Otherwise, it's not that much. Out supply, supply grace, sure, minimum training, reinforcement rate. And no, it's just bad if we'd stay. Yeah, I'm gonna switch. I don't care. Time to switch. This will be advantageous for us in the future. I don't freaking care what anyone says. This is the best way for us right now. Strict bombing, ground support. Let's check naval doctrines. Okay, completely done. So let's do two of them. Yeah, we lost all of that. Not so surprising. Let's go down one more. Go up one more step. Oh, only 49,000 now. Ooh, that. Those 5% must have been super important. But one thing we could always do, if we want to, is go down the left path right here. That's 5% all too. Or, well, this is more organization. That's basically what we need. Just more organization. We are fine with basically production and stuff like that. No, you attack this. Come on. Can't both of you attack at the same time? Holy shit, you're just breaking me instantly. Hmm. But here we are breaking them instantly. Okay. We'll see how this goes. Basically, why I really go for the next path is, if I just get a bit more organization on my tanks, then they will be unstoppable. And what's the best way of getting more organization on your tanks? Well, going down the tank path free. Because this one gives us more breakthrough already. This one gives us 15% more organization for motorized and mech. And well, if we check right here, we have quite a bit of motorized and mech in it. So that will just be first a really good bonus, and we'll see what goes on after that. Technically, we have a bunch of stuff going on with tanks increasing their organization, and well, even more breakthrough, even more organization. So just getting all of that will really just give us a very good bonus. And I think it will be necessary for once we declare war on European Union. We need to be able to hold our ground a bit longer, because as soon as we just deal some damage, it's going to be very hard for them to break us. Right now, attacking, it just takes way too much. And if this doesn't work, well, we can always just revert back to a smaller division. But at least I want to give it a nice try. Yes, one of those ridiculously sized divisions. Because right now, when they don't do a ridiculous amount of damage for us instantly, we're just crushing them. We're basically taking no damage and we're crushing them. So I want to find the perfect balance right here. So let's go to scraping the barrel and then try to go back again and see if that bug still works. No. So we basically need to go down all adult serve, I think. That's 2 million men. What kind of penalty do we have? Factory output minus 20%, construction speed minus 30%, training time plus 30%. It's kind of not that bad, so let's stay with it. Yeah, this is fine. 120 more days. 86 more now. Let's see, do we have any focuses that actually focus on getting more army focus? Not really yet, but quite soon. So we'll see how this goes. Steel production scandal, we need to stop this. Or police power, your speed will increase by 1, 2 more steel. I will just stop this because, well, 2 steel, I don't really care about 2 steel. Shouldn't this increase? Oh yeah, it increases enough to actually have us on several places at the same time. And see there, we lost the battle. Basically, they were doing more damage to us, our organization, than we did to them. But since we attacked from several directions, 3 different directions, means we could have 2 tank divisions at the same time, and they just fell instantly. We just wiped out their entire front lines organization, which means they will fall back. Justification right there. Oh, wait, someone joined the war. I completely forgot to check that. Who was it? Uganda joined the war. Oh, crap. Just bring you down right now, because, well, you have fallen. I completely forgot to check this. Who the hell did actually join the war? Hopefully this would be enough. And you are the faction leader, so hopefully you will... Okay, we'll still have to bring you down. So let's... Oh crap, this looks so ugly. Come on, get over here and fix that. Oh, cool. Please tell me this ends the war. Yes! That's really good. Okay, you 12 divisions, you know what you need to do now. You actually have a war goal against... Okay, the other people. Let's finish them first, and then we can go right there. Actually, half of you. Give me half of this. You assigned against Uganda. The other half. You're gonna be assigned right here. And deal with you. Wait, you can't... No, no, that's just improving relationship. So you are nationalist, and you have... Holy shit. They could have called in the European Union on me. Right, now I want to attack the Social Democrats and I don't want to attack the Nationalists. Oh crap. They could have called in the European Union on me now. That would have been so bad. That would have been really, really bad. So let's not justify war goal against Uganda. Let's instead justify... Take half of these men and, well, I think justify against these people would be nice. Nationalist, no. Social Democrat, you are better. Social Liberal, Angolan, you are Social Democrat. Yeah, cool. Let's pick half of you and just do like this. 75 days, very nice. You declare war. Thank you. Let's see how much damage are we doing right here. Really... NATO joined? NATO. Who are you currently? United Kingdom, Norway, United States, Canada. You are quite many nations. Let's double check faction map mode. So the blue right here. That's the most important part I have to defend against. I bring you down right here, I crush you right here, and if I manage to do stuff... Okay, let's pick 12 divisions right here. Your order is to defend this coastline, or well, maybe not the coastline, but all the good provinces. Okay, really? 84? 84 cities? Are you crazy? It's not... Okay, let's just defend this. Not avian. Let's just defend all ports in this area. Okay. Never mind. You guys. I want 9 divisions stationed right here. If possible. As quickly as possible. You volunteers and European Confederacy want to send 15 volunteers. Sure. I will accept them. Oh god. You won't actually reach this in time. You will just instantly fall. Okay. Let's see. How can I get here? Because I won't be able to bring this down. Let's see if we can get some divisions right here. Because just getting here would be enough. Nope, that won't work. Okay, I'll basically just have to do a naval invasion. Who controls this? Let's see, contested. Okay, very good. Very good, that's the important part. Then my navy should hopefully be safe right here. Which means I need to naval invade. United Kingdom called in several... Okay, they're gonna keep calling in people. I need half of you divisions. You're gonna be deployed right here. Are you in NATO? No, but you are NATO. You're not in NATO. So half of the division. Let's just split it up to different commanders so I don't accidentally mess up different things. You, delete this. Half of you, get over right here. House of supply, not really that great. So I would probably not be able to have that many divisions. So let's split this up even more. 9 divisions, I want from here, you should go into Albania. You 9 divisions, you are the ones that are going down right here to defend against Turkey. Let's see, you are... You 12 divisions, yeah, you should still be going straight in here. You 2 divisions, get in here. Actually, you 6... You are 6 divisions, that should be going right here, and you are 6 divisions going straight here, okay. Very good. I'm sending out my troops now. They're going down. Oof. we're gonna lose some tanks. We're definitely gonna lose some tanks. And we were also nuked. Let's see, did we lose? Really? I think we lost the Fist of the Pope. Both of them. I can't actually see them anymore. No, here. Here they are. I was like, really? You're gonna lose that quickly just after defending our land for so long and so bravely? No, definitely not. I would say, use 17 divisions. You are the ones I have right here, right? Yes. So your order is to defend the main island. Every single point, or not every single point, but every single port. Cool. Just gather up, defend. And let's see, how am I... Oh god, they're just nuking me generally everywhere because they have the superiority. Crap. This might be a tiny bit hard, this war. You guys are retreating, sure. Retreat away, continue on. Come on, let's gather up and then counterattack quite soon. Okay, a bunch of divisions came now to protect us even more. Very nice, thank you for the support. My destroyers are just destroying their fleets, very nice. Our current are the Holy See, 14 missile cruisers, 25 destroyers, thank you. So who's the ones defending? You are defending garrison, let's jump down here. Who's defending garrison? You are attacking, you are attacking. Where's this defending? Yeah, but where's the entire tank division that we're gonna be assigned right here to defend? Is it you? No. Did I accidentally remove you or something? No, it's you, 11, yes. Okay, cool. So your order is to protect this. Basically the coast right here. And let's include this too. As quickly as possible. Since you don't seem to want to go exactly how I want it, so all 11 divisions should go straight there, and then I will assign you to other things. Turkey has been called in. No surprise there. Hopefully I have my division spread out right now. Yes, I have. So let's see if we can push in and bring him down. Wait, you haven't been called in? Who's the one that has been called in then? So, who am I at war with right now? Oh, Turkey. Turkish Egypt. So you are a puppet to them? Yeah, and you have not been called in just yet. Alright. Whatever. I will bring you down soon enough. So, war with NATO. That's how it became. Alright, I'm kind of fine with it. We had to go to war with one of them sooner or later. Okay, United States have not joined the war just yet. You are at 92k losses, alright. Turkey is calling Kurdistan as our enemy, alright. We are bringing them down right here. Okay, very nice. Can you break them right here? Wait, you're falling back? Again? This is weird. You should basically be impossible to break while defending. Oh, there are just so many of them. That's why you're winning. Let's see, how's the supply down? Or how's the air force right there? Not the best. So let's make sure that we actually break them. Let's give them a couple of nukes on the front line. And then, whenever you want to, please just go in here and try to break them. One more nuke and then push in. Very good, very good. And now you've been called in right here, so let's try and push in. Okay, this should go quite fast. Just bring you down. Alright. Going straight here. Yeah, you completely broke them instantly. Very nice. We have no weird naval invasions going on. We have complete control. We have complete our sea around us. That's also very important. 11 tanks right here. Okay. So your orders is now to start garrisoning this entire area, please. Because I doubt they will do any larger... attempts to surround us. like this. And actually, U11, you're kind of useless now to defend this area. Since, well, we don't need it anymore. Let's instead have you also guarding these divisions. Actually, you can include this in your garrison orders. I want you to just defend the ports right here, including you. Cool, 11 divisions, goddammit, you're only 10. Well, fine, whatever. It's cool. All of you guys, please push in right here and see if we can bring down them. Because having these extra 6 divisions would be kind of nice. Research to be done, very nice. Let's continue down this land opening path. Actually, that's 25 more days. Alright. You're now defending this, and you're doing really well. Please attack from this, all three sides at the same time. Actually, you broke instantly, okay. You can attack here. Okay, no, you cannot, because you actually broke them right there too. You can't attack here. Just accept it. You can't break me right here when I'm defending and have the air superiority. As they break. So we basically need to go down this path a bit more. Otherwise, we won't be able to hold on. Our tanks are... Basically, it was the worst possible... Worst timing ever that they could have to attack me. Because my tanks are right now in the processing stadium, going from being kind of decent to really, really good. So yeah, we have a slight problem right now, but sooner or later, or very, very soon, they're gonna be much, much better than they possibly could be with us having mass assault as doctrine. Why we wanted before is we wanted very quickly to get that extra manpower. Right now, well, we have time, all the time in the world on ourselves, so let's just switch out to the best one for tanks. You are 2025, so that's completely fine. Artillery, everything done right here. Knight attack. Oh, we haven't done this one. Cool. Knight attack, best research ever. Alright, delay. Thank you. How much extra organization do you get? 29. Wait, you got almost nothing. You got 2 more organization, I think. That's not a lot. Well, at least it's something. And you're still missing a ton of mechanized. Oh, that might be it. That might actually be it. Why? Alright, you basically just need to reinforce even more. Why am I missing light mechanized? Oh, did I actually assign mechanized? Oh, light mechanized right here. You're supposed to be normal mechanized infantry. Did I do it anywhere else? No. Okay, only one unit. I think. Yeah, but that, now we're missing a lot more right here. 29. What happens if I removed a couple of them? If I remove 2 of them, then we'll be fine in mechanized. If I add 1 more... Alright, then we'll be still fine. Okay, let's do like this then for now. Let's try to gather up a stockpile of them. Or at least not have such a large penalty now and actually have most of our divisions be fully reinforced. Select all. Try to jump in right here. And let's nuke a couple of provinces more. Come on, break them. Come on. Very good. Please attack from both sides now. And they are broken. Very good. You guys, Angolium, bring you down too. Wait, where are you? Yeah, this is the province I want to attack. Or the nation I want to attack. Wait, really? 3 of my divisions attacked and you held us off? That can't be correct. Oh wait, you're pushing in right here. How is that possible? How in hell could you hold that off? Impressive. Please push in right here. Since you are basically done right here, we're gonna just move our airplanes right here and assign you right here. And then we're gonna give them a couple of nukes and we'll see how happy they are after that. Okay, you are now done. Let's continue right here. You capitulated. Awesome, that's a bunch more equipment for us. So let's assign all 12 divisions right here in the north right now. Right here, Turkish Egypt, you are falling. quite quickly, actually. Supply is horrendous, so we'll have to fix that right now. I don't care what it takes. Let's go this way. And you scroll this up. And we have dragged over this episode quite a bit. So we'll see what happens. Will we be able to bring down NATO? Will we fall? Will we just take a billion losses? And will we finally fix our tank divisions? It will take a very long time. It'll probably take 2-3 years to be able to fix it completely. That's at least 1 year, 2 years. Well, we'll see. Thank you guys for joining me for this episode. Like, subscribe, and all the nice stuff. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye and bye.